both.
Hello?
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Feeling good.
Good, good.
Feeling good?
Feeling a lot better, yeah.
I'm glad.
Sure am, I'm lucky to be here.
Yes, you are.
Y'all have a good meeting.
Thanks.
Well, hello, Nydia.
Hello, Dr. Moses. Boy, there are a lot of chairs in the room today.
Wonder why.
I guess they expect a big turnout?
Maybe so.
A little unusual.
Plug into that.
Have your meetings gotten that popular?
Well, I don't know. I'm not expecting many people. I think Ken is going to be sitting down here. They've got county attorney, me, Craig, Pam Livesay, Pam Bowman, Alan. So
I guess there are already some place tags.
Yeah, this is where they had it set.
Okay. I mean,
you may go down there. You get it.
After people arrive, yeah, I don't want to lock the door right now.
Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Nolen.
Hey, how are you?
Great, thank you.
Alan, where do you hail from?
From Markston subdivision up in Northport.
Yeah.
As far as growing up, I grew up in Cherokee County.
Whereabouts in Cherokee?
Here.
Yeah.
Grew up in Holly Springs area.
Because I live over in, I live in Latham Town.
Oh, okay.
Off, you know where Arbor Hill Road is?
Yeah, I know exactly where that is.
Yeah, I live in Orange Souls subdivision. I don't know if you know old Chalky Venable subdivision over there. So.
Yeah,
I know
they're pretty good.
Forsyth County line.
Yeah, it's a nice area.
Yeah, I like it. When I grew, when we first bought there, though, back in 2000, there was nothing out over there. Now there's we've got like a Publix and Kroger's. And we're big stuff.
Yeah, it's changed a lot.
I found that. Keep going.
Oh, that's the Churchill.
Well, Mr. Brown.
Let's see. Who am I spotting? You see anything?
Not there.
Coming up in District 4. Yeah, I'm gonna put you to work.
Where are they going to? Residential, non-residential?
Watercraft repair and horse stable.
Oh, one of them is HOP. That's the one that, we got a moratorium right now on HOPs, and it's somewhat related to that application.
Oh, really?
That one's got some history on it.
Is that the stable or the watercraft repair?
Watercraft.
Watercraft.
Okay.
He had, that guy had a HOP, yeah, I don't know, a decade ago. And it's our opinion that over time, he expanded beyond what he was allowed.
Yeah.
And the only way we could find for him to even have a shot at continuing to do what he does is to reapply under this moratorium. And the only thing we promised him that is that he would have a fighting chance at that point.
Oh, yeah. Not a good fighting chance.
A fighting chance.
Sorry, then it's tail move.
I don't think I've seen that, or heard anything about that yet.
I'm not used to sitting.
Sounds like it.
You'll have to go down there.
All right, we're down there.
I'm gonna, where am I? Gonna be reaching.
Oh, I'm here.
Between you. Okay.
Hello.
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 Hello, how are you?
Just doing you.
Is Mr. Nolen gonna be here today, do we think?
I have no idea. I've not spoken with Mr. Nolen.
I haven't heard that he's not. I still got a couple minutes to spare here, so.
Agreed.
You got me all discombobulated by moving my seat. You know how everybody has their own seat?
Yes.
It's for the recorder. Oh, we changed, that's good. Can I hop in, Pop? You can pick that up. Hey, Jody, do you still got a braised to eat?
The what?
Braised at Cuckoo's Nest, you know that restaurant upstairs?
Oh.
You still eat there?
Might eat there a while, but more than visit.
Are they upstairs?
Well, on the weekends they are.
I never have been downstairs, but.
Yeah, upstairs, I like the food.
The food I had the few times I've been there was good.
Yeah.
They don't publicize that they're.
Well, I mean, they have a ton of people there on the weekends. You know, because they have a band and all that stuff.
Yeah, I've heard the band.
They got some same owners or same group that does Q barbecue.
Oh, really?
I like that, Q barbecue.
Yeah, they kind of combined. They went in and sort of together. The guy brought them in there, you know. And that's when they did the, whatever the name of the place is upstairs.
Braised.
Yeah.
They changed the
name. They changed that when the guy from Q came in.
I didn't know
that.
And
that made it a lot better. But I didn't do it. I've been home a lot. I've been at home a lot lately. Carol's been sick. I've been up in North Carolina. Just take it easy.
When Randy was in that car accident, his pelvis was broken and they had to put a big plate and screws to hold it.
That's what I was gonna say, to hold it.
Hi, Nydia. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
Hey, Amber.
Hi, Pete.
My nerves are just fractured, so it's just fine.
Hi, Pete.
Hey, Doc.
Good.
Good. Huh? Good to see you.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Pete.
Oh, what changed?
See, it's doing the same thing for you it did to all of us.
Yeah,
you're right. Reviews have gone up a lot on that, and Q's reviews are really good. Still haven't eaten there.
Good stuff.
Yeah. That Braise is good. Everything I've had there has been pretty good.
Yeah, the guy that owns Q used to be part of the
part owners down with Greenwood and Roswell.
Oh, and Roswell? I didn't know that.
Yeah, because I'm friends with D Greenwood.
I'm just going to do.
But he broke off and started the one right there. And I was right on Highway 9 and had a second one.
So you can hear better?
Well, yeah.
I think they come back to portion size though, like you, the one they first opened.
Did they?
It used to be there, I couldn't.
Well, it's not like Swallow's Hollow.
I couldn't finish the ladder. I remember there about 3 weeks ago and finished it and I was looking for other, I was looking for my wife's to taste on our car.
You know, there's one on, in Milton, on Highway 9.
That's the, that was his first one.
Well, okay, we have four members and it's, let me give them a couple minutes grace here. We want to start it up. It's our new recording device.
Is it working?
Yes.
I'd like to call the meeting to order. Is there a motion to adopt the agenda?
Madam Chairman, before you, you start, and I should mention this while we were just sitting here talking, would it be agreeable if the commission would see fit to make a motion and second to put number 5 before number 1 so I can, before we embark on doing all the cleanup from the 19th, if we can talk about the 19th first and the 26th, would that be agreeable?
Let me see if I can get a motion.
Yes, ma'am.
I'd like to make a motion that we move item number 5, discussion regarding February 19th vote for officers and future handling, to the first item.
Yes, ma'am.
Tonight?
Yes, ma'am.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Everyone vote? That passes. So number 5 will go to number 1.
Thank you.
Now a motion to adopt the agenda as amended.
I move to adopt the agenda as amended.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries. So number 1 will be discussion regarding February 19th vote for officers and future handling.
Madam Chairman, thank you for that. And let me just go ahead and start. You all know who I am. I'm Ken Girard, the county attorney. And so thank you for letting me speak to you, members of the commission. Let me just start it off this way. I think most of us know, or at least have an idea, that since the February 19th meeting, there have been a lot of issues, or at least a lot of concerns that have been raised to me, and I believe to Tom Brown as well, with respect to not only the 19th meeting, but also the 26th meeting, and sort of the fallout, and sort of the ancillary issues and events since then. And so my objective today is to approach you with a lot of humility and hope that we can have a constructive conversation about all those things that have occurred. I want to admit some things to you that I wish I had done better, as far as particularly the February 19th meeting that I was at. But then also just see if we can figure out if we have a sort of a commonality of what occurred on the 19th, and then just figure out what went wrong, if anything, and then move forward and sort of clear the decks if we can and move forward. So that's my objective today, and I'm going to try to lead this as much as I can. I've talked with Tom, you know, what do we think, how do you think I ought to do this? And the best I could come up with is I'm just going to try to walk you through the facts as I understand them. You know, facts sometimes are in the eye of the beholder, but I'm going to try to walk you through my understanding of the facts. And I've asked Tom to please jump in, not just to interrupt me if I'm wrong, but just to jump in even if there's some things he would like to add to or embellish or, you know, further explain. And then hopefully, you know, I can get some feedback from the members of the commission themselves. So let me just start. That's the only way I know to do it. I know to do it. We'll just start. The issues I'm here to talk about preliminarily are the February 19th election of officers. The agenda item was the election of officers, and as I understand it, there's no tape. There's no official tape recording of that meeting. I have a tape that was made, but it's not the official tape, and it doesn't capture everything. It captures just a little bit of the time period. If we need to resort to that and listen to it, we can, and I may even want to. But I want to get into the mechanics of this because there's been some questions raised to me. You know, what did we do on the 19th? Did we nominate versus did we appoint? Was it some other thing that we did? And so I just at least want to give you a glimpse into what I was thinking. all right? And this may be a dark and dangerous place to know what I was thinking, but I'm going to at least tell you what I was thinking and sort of walk you through why I was thinking. I don't have a tape of this with respect to the first motion that was made. Let me just be very candid about that. I don't have it recorded as far as the first motion that was made. I believe the first motion that was made was a motion to nominate Pam Livesay to serve as chairman. Okay, that's what I believe the motion that was made was, which I had a tape, but I don't. Then something, not curious, but just something interesting occurred. There was discussion, of course, why I nominate you? Why was that being done? There was this give and take back and forth. But the motion, before it got a second, there was some discussion, but before it got a second, there was an opening during the discussion where you said, and again, I'm not getting into personalities, I'm just trying to recount the facts, where you said, perhaps we need to see if there are any other nominations. And there weren't any other nominations. And then there was. Then you said, okay, well, do we have a second? And a second came, I believe, from Craig Nolen. So at that point then, we had a motion to appoint Pam Livesay as chairman, to serve as chairman. We had discussion. Then we had a request, were there any additional nominations? There were none. Then we had a second. Then we had a little bit of an additional discussion, and then there was a vote in favor. Excuse me, that's not fair. There was a vote 2-2, I believe, with Mr. Nolen and Mr. Moses voting in favor of you to be chairman, and you and Ms. Bowman voting against.
So can we dispute what you're saying at this point?
Absolutely. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I think there's a lot of discrepancies in what you're saying.
Okay.
Number one, we asked for nominations. I was nominated by Dr. Moses.
Yes.
And immediately I said, I have asked not to be reappointed, therefore would decline a nomination. Then it went on, and it was seconded. And there was no call for any additional nominees at that point. It was a 2-2 vote at that point right there. Then I said, wait a minute, can we not nominate anyone else? And we were told, no, everything stops right here. Dead in the water, which I totally could not understand because we were just nominating. And a nominee can take their name out of the hat. That's not the election. So to me, it should have been a wash. It should have started nominees, floor open. Who would like to be chair? But we never got there. So that is my understanding of what transpired. I don't know if anyone, well, you were not here, so you can't.
Well, I can assure you respectfully that before there was a second made, there was a call for additional nominations.
After.
Do you want me to play it?
If you've got it on tape, certainly.
I mean,
can I? Let me say something. It's my understanding that some people thought there's a policy that would go by on elections. I mean, I heard you say that.
No, we went by what staff gave us.
You said that on the 26th.
No, I said there was a sheet that we were given that was used like a guideline that we thought we were going to use. And that's what I had written on and Pam had written on.
But you definitely said that there's a policy. And my question is.
Well, it isn't a policy. If I said that, I was incorrect when I said it. I meant guideline.
But it's on tape.
Okay, that's fine.
If there is a policy, I want to see it. You know, and it says here, copies of this chapter and rules and procedures adopted by the Planning Commission shall be available for distribution to the general public. So, you know, if there's a policy, I'd like to see it. I'm not aware of a policy.
There's not a policy.
No, there's not a policy. I think that also you asked if the Board of Commissioners used this same process.
No, I didn't say that.
Well, in the meeting of the 26th, you asked about that.
No, I didn't. I didn't ask that.
May I finish?
Yes, but that's not true.
And I said, yes, they used the same guidelines that we went by, and then I gave you the transcript that I had transposed of exactly what happened when the Board of Commissioners did their elections.
I've got that right here.
So it was, you know, exactly like the sheet that we've been given.
Yeah, and it's been brought to my attention that...
And I realize that that's not policy, that was a guideline that we were given to go by, and...
But this was a public meeting, it was misleading the public, and it... We can get to that later, too. I mean, maybe we'll stay with the 19th meeting, but the piece of paper that you handed me that you tore out's right here, I've got it right with me. And some people think that Pam was quoting from this, but she wasn't.
Pam doesn't have that, I don't think. She only had that sheet of paper.
Yeah, I don't, she was reading.
She was reading that blank sheet of paper that she had.
That's what I was given at the meeting when I arrived last week.
This blank sheet of paper?
Yes, that's what I went by, totally, from staff.
But then you were reading from something that sounded like you were reading from the minutes.
No, her sheet has stuff written on it because she wrote on it last week.
Oh, okay.
No, her, she wrote on it at that work session to keep up with what was happening.
Where is that sheet?
Do you have it with you?
You were offered that sheet at the meeting because Pam offered it, and I was offering to pass it over.
No, that was this.
That was that sheet, because I was looking over trying to figure out what that sheet was as well.
This sheet.
And all the sheet said was Pam Livesay, and then it said Craig Nolen. I mean, that's, because that's as far as we ever got. We never got any further than that. Well, you did have it? Okay.
Yeah, it's the sheet.
Okay.
And it states what she said, motion by, and it just has the names. Uh-huh. It wasn't a full...
No, and that was it. That's where we stopped.
But there's one thing about it. We didn't agree to do this. This is not policy. And I don't know where this came from.
It came from staff.
Staff.
How
did staff come up with this? Because this is a major departure from
departure from what?
From the way we've elected officers in the past.
There's no policy on how we elect officers. The staff copied what the Board of Commissioners had just done in January, thinking that the board that appointed us would be a good board to model our system after. Looking back at it,
did somebody tell you to do this, or was it, or did you come up with it yourself?
No one told us to do that.
Did you come up with it yourself, or did somebody else come up with it?
Teresa came up with it.
Okay.
It follows the same lines as what the chair has for the meeting, correct?
Why did you come up with this, Teresa?
As Tom said, I thought it would be a good model since the Board of Commissioners had just used
it. Did any of the commissioners ask you to come up with this?
No, sir.
I have a question for Ken. In the absence of procedures, if the chairman takes and uses a certain framework such as that, then is that considered acceptable? There's some room for discretion at that point, because I might say that system doesn't work. I don't like that system. There's nothing in place, so what do you use?
Right, and we're going to talk about that, I mean, as we get through this.
You'll see on the tape that it says we're not going to go by this. We made a decision not to use this.
Well, let's let Ken finish. Okay. We interrupted, and I apologize.
And that's no worries at all.
Well, let me just read two more things, Ken, if you don't mind, then I'll finish. But I'd just like to get this out front here. Because there's some consternation over nominations or votes. And here's some has anybody bothered to find out the definition of a nomination? I have. Here's World English Dictionary. To appoint to an office or position. To propose as a candidate, especially for elective office. Nomination. The act or instance of appointing a person to office. That's another. Here's one. Another one. To appoint or propose appointment to office or place. To propose a candidate for election to office. Okay. Now, the only other thing here is, as Ken said, I made a motion to nominate Pam Livesay to serve as chairman. I'm going to read you a few things. Let me read the first one from President Obama. This is Inez Tenenbaum, was nominated by President Obama on June the 9th to serve as chairman of the United States Product Safety. She was then sworn into office. That's nominated to serve. Chuck Hagel, this just happened. On January the 7th, 2013, President Obama nominated Hagel to serve as Secretary of Defense. The Senate Armed Forces approved his nomination. There was not all this stuff here, and here's something from a local.
But there was an approval process.
Yeah, I think Congress.
Yeah.
No, there was not an approval. There was an election. There was an election. Here's another one.
And that is their procedure.
The chairman. This is for some county here somewhere. But so the chairman asked for other nominations to serve on the Putnam County Fair Board. The chairman asked the commissioners to vote on the nominations. So forth and so forth. Were then elected Putnam County Board 3 terms. In other words, they were nominated, then they were elected. So it's the normal course of events that when you nominate somebody, particularly if there are no rules, it's the normal course of events to nominate somebody and then have an election.
That's never, any board I've ever been on, they ask for nominees, you get a slate of nominees, and then the body votes on the people that are nominated.
When you were elected chairman, that didn't happen.
No, because no one else wanted to be chairman.
There never was an opportunity for anybody.
I wanted to
say a few things about the word nomination to get things in perspective.
I wanted to maybe go chronologically and then.
Okay.
And then get to those issues, because I think that's something. I mean, the reality is the Board of Commissioners used a procedure in January and that involved nominations and that involved a subsequent election by the body. And I'm going to talk to the chairman. He and I didn't rehearse this. In fact, the chairman may think this is a bad idea, but I do think that to do a two-step process, a nomination and then an election process in a body this small, is probably a little procedurally awkward. The reality is if I make a motion for anyone to be chairman and there is no support for that person to be chairman, they won't be elected chairman. You see what I'm saying? They will simply be, the three people won't vote in favor of that. So it seems like the whole nomination element seems to add another layer to it. And again, this goes back to February 19th. That's my fault. When I was here, it's at your meeting. I didn't call a timeout or anything like that. And quite frankly, I hadn't seen that. But that doesn't matter. Your question was, what do you do when you don't have a protocol or procedure? That's what we're going to get at today. And again, that you didn't have one. So that's what we're going to try to divine today, is then what was everyone's expectation. I want to go back, though, if I can, just chronologically, and understand, Madam Chairman, I'm not attempting to take you on at all.
And I'm not either.
That
I just want to get this settled.
Nothing to do with this. So that's not my objective. I just want, it's important for me for you to understand sort of the decision-making process. So when I play this, the objective is not to do any sort of a one-upsmanship or an aha. It's simply, this is what I heard, and there's no, I think, Chairman Livesay, you are correct. After the motion was a tie, you did raise the question, what about other nominations?
Well, do you have on there where I have asked not to be nominated?
I have everything there was to have. So everything that was on, but let me just play this and see.
It's just profoundly
overrated. No, it's too late.
I'm just saying, I'm trying to honor your
Saying.
Yes, ma'am. That's as early as it's picked up.
Okay. Because prior to that, I said, I made my disclaimer. I have asked not to be.
I remember that.
Yeah. I mean, I couldn't understand why it went on from that point, because I said, I have asked not to be reappointed. Therefore, I would decline any kind of nomination because I'm not going to be on the board.
And it may be. Quite frankly, that may actually become academic, depending upon what the outcome is of the additional vote being cast.
Yes.
Because the reality is, when we get to that on the agenda today, you are here to cast that vote. And even if Mr. Nolen is not here, the way it works is the votes on the minutes stand as cast. You will then be asked to make your vote. Now, we're not there yet,
sure.
But I'm simply, that's the way the process will work, so we can get to that. I only wanted to raise that to say, we had this process where a motion was made, and your statements, I understand, your position was this is not capturing the entire story. I get that. We had a motion made, discussion, then a call for additional nominations. None were forthcoming, and whether that was just because of the awkwardness of the procedure or what. And then there was a second, and then there was a vote, and it was a 2-2. So you may say, okay, well, Ken, what were we doing? Were we nominating? In other words, if that had been a passed motion, would we then have taken another action to then have actually made the appointment, or would that have been the election itself? Based upon the procedure we were using at that time, and, you know, quite frankly, you and I have discussed this, I know your intention was this was to select Pam Livesay as chairman.
That's what I said. What I tried to point out to you that most other people
And in the absence of any additional nominations, my position was going to be that if you vote in favor, we're done. Pam Livesay is the chairman. If you vote against, the deck is cleared, and we have to. I'm not going to have new nominations today. We're not going to have additional nominations. If someone wants to make a motion for chairman, we make a motion for chairman. And that would be my request.
But one other thing that kind of concerned me was after, I mean, I heard, what I heard was after the vote, Chairman Livesay says, what do we do now?
Because it was tied, I think. Why she asked that. She didn't.
It's tied.
Have you ever read the bylaws?
Yes, but I declined.
It says what you do now. I know.
Yes, but I declined.
It's not funny.
That.
It's sad.
It shouldn't
because
have
it
even
spells
gone
out
to a
what
vote,
you do.
Period.
You've been there for 16 years and
Jody,
don't know.
I declined before any of that happened, and I could not understand why I was not allowed to back myself out, but I was told not to. I was told to proceed.
Then
we proceeded, and that's.
And we didn't get to this point, but then even after you were told to. What the bylaws said, which I don't think you understood, but even after you were told that, you continued on saying, Alan Neal will be here. Can we wait till the end of the meeting and vote? Which totally goes against what the bylaws says, but you were suggesting that.
Jody, from the very beginning, it should have been a wash. You don't, a nominee does not have to be nominated if they decline. You cannot make a person run for an office they decline. They do not want to do.
And to be candid with you, I don't recall your unwillingness that's wrong. If you're telling me that is, I mean, I will take your word.
That's the statement.
I'm not taking.
That's why we were all of a miss when it went through that whole thing, that I could not take myself out, and now we have, who would like to be chair?
That's your statement, in my opinion, did not happen.
Well, that's why I voted no, because she adamantly said, I have asked not to be reappointed.
I voted against myself.
She voted against, you know.
I mean, why would I have voted against myself?
I knew that I could have voted yes. We could have closed the nominations. I could have reopened the nominations because Jody had said, out of respect for her and her office.
I remember that.
Yeah.
I could have done that and then we could have started over again. But I wasn't sure anyone even knew that we could do that. But then when it was tied, we couldn't proceed at all. We were stuck. We just had to stop.
Which is correct. And that's the procedurally correct thing to do. I mean, even the Board of Commissioners has gotten stymied by that before, because it shuts down everything else until that tie is broken. And obviously, Craig Nolen must not have understood it as well either, as he seconded and then voted in favor of it. So I apologize to the extent I did not understand. You were ardently saying, I don't want to do this and will not accept it if I'm appointed. I didn't understand.
I never heard that.
I didn't understand that.
That's why you went on to say, with respect.
That's not why
you
I said
did.
That.
Well, you heard me say that.
No, I didn't hear. I just finished saying I didn't hear you say that.
Wow.
Let's keep going. Okay, so we had that one. We had the tie. And we had the rule, and that'll be broken today. All right, and then we'll have that issue behind us, and that will be addressed. The next one had to do with Craig Nolen. That situation was much quicker. There, you had a motion by Commission Member Bowman, seconded by Commission Member or Chairman Livesay, for Craig Nolen to be secretary, and then a discussion ensued, and quite frankly, the discussion was whether or not we needed the office of secretary at all, is what I seem to remember. I think there was some discussion about Tom Brown serving in the secretary post.
To which you said no.
To which, well, because I think the chairman made a good point, you know, does that mean that Tom Brown will run the meetings in his absence, and that would be a very difficult thing to do, unless we totally reorganize the Planning Commission to have a dedicated hearing officer that's not a member, and that's not the way it's set up right now. So that didn't make a tremendous amount of sense to me for Tom to be put in that position at this point. Then the chairman then did what a lot of chairmen do, which is they do a sum-up statement. And the sum-up statement was the motion and second is for Craig Nolen to be secretary. And then there was a motion, or then there was a vote, and it was, of course, unanimous for those members present, I believe. Mr. Neal, you weren't here yet.
That's correct. I wasn't here.
So Mr. Neal's not here. And, okay, so that's where we are, and then we moved on to additional business. Okay, so I think both motions were to nominate. We've sort of gone through ad nauseum the Livesay vote on the Livesay appointment, and then the Craig Nolen vote was very quick. And, again, the only, I guess I would say, the only strangeness there was that you had a motion to nominate, followed by a sum-up statement to be, and of course then, and I say this with all, you know, respect to everybody, if the intention was that that was only a nomination to nominate Craig Nolen, shouldn't there have been an immediate subsequent motion to have appointed?
Or to close the nomination.
Dependent upon the policies or
yeah.
procedures
yeah.
we're following, yes ma'am. And again, I was here. I didn't make you all do that. But again, you know, when I walked away from here, and I say I'm getting a little ahead of myself, but it bears back directly to what everybody's thought process was. We immediately got into, Tom and I got into the issue of who was going to run the next meeting, the February 26th meeting. And Tom and I did have this debate, and I issued an opinion to Tom where I said, based upon the chairman position being in flux, and based upon the Nolen secretarial appointment being clear and definite, my position is that Craig Nolen will run the next meeting. I'm not saying that to make a point or prove I'm right. I'm simply saying my mindset walking out of here was Craig Nolen was elected. Okay? So that's the end as far as the officers at the February 19th meeting. All right. Then we get into the agenda summary following the meeting. The agenda summary initially said that I think that Craig Nolen had been appointed, but that was subsequently changed. The agenda summary, which is basically just this sort of fairly informal document that's supposed to kind of get a snapshot of the business that transpired at the meeting. It's not as official as minutes, but it's still nonetheless required by the Act. So now you're all looking at me going, okay, well, what is the point of all this? The point of this is primarily to clear the air. I mean, I think the best outcome, quite frankly, we've already done some of that, is to hear your all's position on this, which is good for me as well, because I hadn't heard some of this from you all. And also to just learn from the experience, dust ourselves off, and hopefully move on such that this doesn't occur again, or these sorts of things don't occur, and we can make it perfect next time. So we had the agenda summary come out, and then I believe on February 25th, we had a draft of the minutes came out. I believe, though, after my opinion came out that I believe Craig Nolen was going to run the meeting on the 26th, I believe that opinion was communicated, at least to the individuals involved, which would have been Madam Chairman, you, perhaps you, Dr. Moses, and at least Craig Nolen was advised of this as well. I believe, and again, I call this out, Madam Chairman, not to point a finger at you, but just to say, I think your response back when Tom said that was, no, I don't think Craig Nolen was appointed. I think he was nominated. And therefore, it's not clear then that he will be running the meeting on the 26th.
No.
Okay.
What my point was is that I was still chair because I was not voted out of being chair, so therefore I would be presiding over the meeting because nothing had changed.
Okay.
I was still, and that's what I had said to Tom, and that's why he went to you. That was totally, no, it had nothing to do with Craig whatsoever.
Is that what she said to you, Tom?
Well, you know, having had a lot of discussions over the last couple of weeks, and none of them do you always anticipate the focus that will be placed on them a week, 2 or 3 weeks in the future. My mental notes of that, I had the impression that it was more about Craig being nominated, but I can't say that like a fact. Mm-hmm.
So you don't remember exactly like Pam was chairman, so yeah.
Pretty informal discussion at the time. Yeah. I took away from it. I thought the focus of it was that Craig had been nominated, not mm-hmm. elected. But the main point of what she called about was she disagreed with the final decision, which was who was running the meeting.
Yeah, that was my whole.
So yeah, I just, you know, like many discussions and things, in hindsight, after all this, you can say, "Oh, I wish I would have." Took better notes on that, or I wish I would have mentioned this or mentioned that, and it's one of those things. I can't tell you exactly what the point was. I can tell you that the overall theme was, Tom, I think the wrong person is running the meeting based on the decision you made.
Yeah, and the 2-2 tie, I mean, that nothing was ever
resolved. Did you call and talk to anybody else other than Tom?
Well, I had called her, she spoke to me.
Actually, you and I talked. We see each other.
Yeah, because I felt like we had not completed Craig's nomination.
Did you contact staff?
Later I did, yes. Going over and over. Well, I have a timeline that I was going to give the attorney so he could look at my timeline of exactly what I did.
So did you write or call?
Both.
Who did you talk to?
I talked to Teresa when I called.
Push yourself.
On Friday, we talked to each other.
I talked to Teresa on Wednesday.
Oh, you talked to her, okay.
Yeah.
I don't want to throw anybody under the
bus. Yeah, I mean, there's no bus.
Just some misunderstandings, and things have been blown completely out of proportion, I believe. I think some mistakes were made, and we're trying to rectify those mistakes.
Well, I think the thing that got blown out of proportion is the word nominate. That's what I wanted to
do. Well, I knew that I had used the word nominate.
Nothing happened until y'all started contacting and saying it's nominate, it's not elect.
Well, I didn't hear that, that's what it was, and that's what we were given at the meeting, so.
But things got blown out of proportion when y'all started contacting.
No.
You and.
I knew that I had, I did talk to you, I believe, because right afterwards sometime, and I said I believe that something didn't completely get finished, because I knew that I had used the word nominate for Craig Nolen. I would like to nominate Craig Nolen for secretary. And then someone seconded it, and then we voted, but the nominations were never closed, and no one was ever appointed. No one was ever elected. There wasn't a second election, so I thought we didn't finish this. Craig was only nominated.
For the election.
For the election of, and we never completed the whole process.
She completed it, because she wanted, you can listen, I think the tape cut off, but as soon as he was elected, Pam went right on to the next order of business. She didn't call to close the nomination. If there was, that's why I think it, what y'all were trying to say, I think it appears to me that you all are trying to finagle this election after the election by saying it was just a nomination. Why didn't you follow through at the meeting?
I think we thought we did elect Craig as the secretary at the meeting. I think we thought we did. But then afterwards, when we look at this, we're not so sure.
This does not come into play anywhere.
Well, it did that night.
No, it didn't.
It did that night.
There's a discussion we had a discussion not to even use that.
I
think it's difficult. I mean, I agree that no one approved that. The significance of that document, though, is that I'm hearing that others found it significant. I mean, is it fair to say that you thought you were following that document, whether it was approved or not?
But it came from Teresa. This did not come from the Planning Commission.
Well, that's irregardless.
But that doesn't make any difference.
It was a guideline. It's the same thing as the chair. I don't know if you realize every month there is a script that we go by from staff.
I already answered that question.
Yeah. Oh.
She's already answered that question.
She came up with it herself.
Using what the Board of Commissioners
said. So I know I second guessed after the fact. Did we really?
I don't know why.
Did we really elect?
We changed
Craig.
The way we elect.
There was no problem with Craig being secretary, but did we go through proper procedures to do that? I don't think anyone had a problem with Craig being secretary.
I'm curious. I mean, that wouldn't even matter as far as who presided over the next meeting if the tie vote meant that there wasn't a vacancy.
There wasn't.
Well, I do know.
Is there a vacancy in a tie vote?
I do.
Well,
know.
I mean, forgive me. Go ahead if you want to finish.
I do know there is a significant thing that. I was in Tom's office, and Craig Nolen came in. I'm sorry he's not here to confirm this, but he did say, I asked him, and he did say that he had an agreement with Pam Bowman that he was going to nominate her, and she was going to nominate him. And they had this little quid pro quo. I'm not saying anything was wrong with it, but
I know for a fact that the last election, and I don't know about this one, that you personally called people up and solicited them.
I'm not saying anything's wrong with it. I'm just saying that was the arrangement. Oh. So the arrangement was there. Craig told me that himself.
I don't think.
And so that's why that's why. There was no problem with Craig being secretary, because that's what Pam wanted. But there was a problem with the way the chairman election worked out, because Craig was too slow to make his nomination, or he never nominated.
I asked not to be nominated.
I'm not talking about
period.
You. I'm talking about Craig. Craig didn't get around to nominating you, as y'all had agreed.
I never agreed to that with Craig. Craig was never going to nominate me for chairman. I never asked him to do that. He was not going to nominate me for chairman. I'm sorry that he is not here to speak to this, but I did not ask him to nominate me for chairman.
Commission Member Neal, let me address your question. My legal opinion, first of all, the chairman of the Planning Commission does not have a term. The only requirement with respect to the officers of the Planning Commission is there has to be an election at least once every 2 years. Mm-hmm. But there's no term. A board member has a term, judges have terms. The officers of the Planning Commission don't have terms. Now, the officers don't have terms. Mm-hmm. The Planning Commission members themselves has terms. Those terms run contemporaneous with the membership of the district commissioner that appoints them. So they have a term as well. But the officers, so, you know, and again, you know, Chairman Livesay and I have not addressed this between us. I may respectfully disagree with her that because her appointment or the appointment of a chairman was not final, she automatically continues to serve, but it doesn't really matter. But that, I say this to say, the information I got back was not that that was the concern. The information I got back was it was felt very strongly that it was a nomination and not an appointment. And if that's not the case, then I apologize for that too. That's
yeah, just I just thought that important. The chair position was not vacated. It was.
And if it had been a typical term, there's such thing as called a holdover capacity, where if your term expires, you sort of keep functioning in that role. Sure. I just don't feel in the absence of a term for officer, you're in a holdover capacity as a Planning Commission member right now. You're in that 90-day window. But as an officer, I didn't feel like there was one. So I want you to understand that was why I concluded that. And this is good discussion. And let's just keep going through it, because there's a few more things we need to get to the bottom of, and then we'll be sort of wrapping it up. The draft minutes were in fact put together by staff and were emailed to the Planning Commission members, I believe, the Monday before the 26th meeting. Those minutes, the draft minutes, contained nominate in both places, which, based upon the discussion we're having today, would appear to have been the correct verbiage. I know that we may have a disagreement on what nomination meant, but at least the word usage was correct. But the draft minutes did contain Craig Nolen in the signature block of the minutes. Is that in the draft
minutes? As secretary.
As secretary. And of course, if there was a question as to whether or not he had actually been appointed as secretary, and in fact it was only a nomination, that wouldn't presumably be appropriate. Okay, so that was circulated on the 25th. Now, let's go to the 26th then.
Well, also, Pam was listed as chairman. And at that point in time, according to my feeling, she was not chairman because it was
right,
in limbo.
Of the typo, right. That's right. So that's worthy of note. That's right.
Yeah, so Pam was listed as chairman and Craig was listed as secretary.
After those draft
one of them was correct and one of them was wrong.
I would say that was probably how everybody, from the sounds of it, that's how everybody left, thinking that it was.
No.
That Craig?
No. Everybody thought Craig had been elected, but Nobody thought that Pam had been elected, because it was made absolutely clear by Ken that there was no chairman. And that means, if you've read the bylaws, do you know what the bylaws say about that?
Yes, I'm very well aware.
What do the bylaws say?
The bylaws on officers. It states that Planning Commission shall elect their officers consisting of a chairman, secretary from among the members every 2 years or at the next regular meeting after a vacancy of one or more of the officers. The election of all officers shall be by majority vote. So if there's not a majority,
then... But then what does it say about the secretary?
The secretary shall oversee the maintenance of minutes and records. The secretary shall assume the responsibilities of the chairman in his or her absence.
Okay, and we had an absence of a chairman.
I don't understand that. Yeah, I mean,
there was no chairman. There's a void for the chairman because it was a tie vote.
So does a tie vote mean that the acting chairman then is no longer chair? And if
what the rules require is that every 2 years you have to elect an officer. Mm-hmm. We tried, and at a minimum on the issue of chairman, we failed. We didn't elect a new officer. If it's as easy to then, therefore, the existing chairman just stays in place after you try and fail once, mm-hmm. then that'd be an easy way to get around that rule. You see my point? Mm-hmm. And so that was why I concluded the way. There was no advantage from me trying to. That's just the way I came up with it. I mean, I don't know who was going to be elected chairman. I don't know what your vote's going to be. We've never talked about it. But
yeah, I mean, that's
it had nothing to do. I can guarantee you this with the personalities of any of these positions.
It was a void.
And I didn't ever hear you say we have no chairman.
I did not say that at the meeting. In fact, the only position I have taken on that point would have been in my email to Tom.
Okay. I assumed that since it was a tie vote, then the chair would remain in place, knowing that we had to break the tie the next month and we would move from there.
And just so you'll understand my rationale, you know that obviously Pam Livesay served as chairman of the 26th meeting, and the reason for that was when I found out that even the secretary position was a nomination, and I thought that that meant that the intention of the planning commission was he hadn't been appointed either. I'll just be very candid with you. This isn't a very legal position, but you sort of throw your hands up and say, well, if both positions are in flux and are unclear, then status quo has got to be preserved. And if you were to say, well, Ken, what's your authority for that? It'd be Ken on the law on that one, because I don't know any other way to say it. But when it was clear to me that Craig Nolen had been appointed secretary, in the face of that certainty, I felt comfortable that he would then run the meeting in the absence of a duly appointed bona fide chairman. And that's why I came up with the opinion I came
up with. And Pam, with all due respect, our bylaws do address. We don't have much in the way of bylaws, and that's why it baffles me that we have such a hard time understanding some of this, and that you weren't even aware of it. But it says, in the event of a tie vote, the motion shall be deemed automatically postponed. It doesn't say
to the next meeting.
To the next meeting.
Until the next meeting.
To the next meeting.
Yes.
I questioned if it just says the next meeting, does that mean we do this at the public hearing?
You do.
Yeah, the very next
meeting. And I was told, well, no, it means the next like meeting.
You're off on a different tangent than what I was trying to. You interrupted me, which is okay. But what you did is you're answering a question that I wasn't asking. You asked a different answer. What I was trying to say here is it does not say the motion shall be deemed automatically. It says the motion will be automatically postponed. It doesn't say the chairman will continue to act in her capacity.
It says postponed, so nothing would change. Status quo. I think it does say that.
Show me where it says.
I mean, I thought that was postponed.
Postponed means there's no action done. That means it's nothing.
Like
zero.
It can't remain a tie. I would have to break the tie, or else it would be vacated, and there'd be another election. So
we had a person elected to take over, and when we didn't elect a chairman, we did not elect a chairman. Now that's, I mean, you keep trying to say. We have this chairman. We did not elect a chairman. There was an absence of a chairman. In the absence of a chairman, the secretary is charged with assuming the duties of the chairman. And there was an absence of a chairman because the election turned up a void in that spot.
Let me tell you, from my perspective, the only thing that caused me to question myself was when I found out that there was some dispute as to whether Craig Nolen
had been appropriately elected. And when I heard that, then I began to question, because I was very comfortable otherwise that Craig could run the meeting. It was not intended to take away from you, had nothing to do with that. It was just, that was what I was comfortable. When I found out, though, that issue too was in flux, that's when I hedged with Tom. And I said, well, if that's true, and the purpose, quite frankly, of this meeting tonight, today, is to sort all this out and hear it and get to the bottom of it. Because I think, Pam Livesay, what I heard you say was, you did in fact believe everybody left the 19th meeting believing Craig Nolen had been appointed as the secretary. I suspect what you were about to say then was, it was simply the words of the piece of paper that made you question.
Yeah, when I looked at it and I saw we didn't get any further than that, when I looked at, pulled that out on Wednesday, that I happened to have still in the car, and it's like, now I'm saying, I don't think we got past a nomination on Craig either.
No, because when she and I talked about it, she said, well, didn't I then move forward and say, do I have a motion to close the nominations? And I said, no, we did it once. It was,
and that was it.
4-0. We did it once.
Actually, and no one's disputing this, but the actual sum up statement was, okay, so we have a motion and second for Craig Nolen to be elected secretary.
Yeah. And that was the wording, see, that I didn't, it just... Mm-hmm.
And so
I just knew that we hadn't finished.
So what was the vote on Craig Nolen?
4-0.
Because you don't have it on there.
I didn't write it down.
Yeah,
I thought finished. It was yours. You said you
we both had those sheets.
Oh, y'all.
I just happened to have
y'all
that
got
in
together and we're okay.
Let me again. We're getting to the end of this of my story here. The draft minutes get circulated, and as we noted, they contain nominate, Livesay chairman, Craig Nolen secretary. Then, of course, the issues raised, well, is Craig Nolen need to be in the secretary block if we're saying that it is unclear if he was, in fact, voted in to be the secretary? My understanding is that in the minutes, this is before they are approved in the 26th, the minutes are changed to reflect that it's basically pure status quo. Livesay, Bowman, other three members. My understanding is also, though, that those minutes were then not circulated by way of the email back to the members. However, I do understand that at least three phone calls were made advising of some, here's where we're going, here's what's going to happen tonight, won't be Craig Nolen running the meeting. I hope I'm getting that right. But not every member is contacted, but I think three are. The three impacted them.
I called Pam Livesay, Craig Nolen, and Jody. The one person who's Craig, because he was the person that would or would not be running the meeting based on that decision. And Pam and Jody, because those are the two people that had called me prior to that. Okay. And Ken did a nice job of summarizing it. I called up those three members and described my change in position and who was going to be running the meeting. Now, I didn't go, I made an assumption, and it was a bad assumption, that people would automatically assume, and that change would show up in the minutes, the signature block of the minutes would be changed. On that phone call, I never said that. I never said, oh, and the signature block of the minutes will be changing. It was like a lot of this, it was a last minute working under a close deadline, an afternoon where I already had a long work session upstairs, didn't have that much time, didn't think we had time necessarily to email them out. Maybe people would have already been away from home for the day before the meeting. Called those three members, described the outcome of the change, but again, looking in hindsight, I wish I would have also said, and this is going to be reflected in the minutes. I made an assumption that...
But even so, that's not the way you change the minutes, though.
Jody, the draft minutes at that point. That's something you don't get, I realize.
That was draft minutes.
So the content of the minutes that we received a week prior, the content didn't change. It was just the signatures?
Signature block.
Okay. A week prior?
No.
Monday
morning.
Okay.
Yeah.
Monday the 25th, you got emailed
I guess
the draft minutes.
Yeah.
the next day, that morning.
That's what you were looking at the meeting, I think.
Ken and I had discussed, and I made my final decision that I felt like I had to change my initial decision. Called three members, described the change, and made the corresponding change in the signature block.
Okay.
But the minutes that I tried to see, which I couldn't see because nobody had it. But you said you had it because you had it on your phone, but you told me you didn't have it. But
no,
you
I said had it. It.
He had it pulled
I said
up.
I had it
yeah.
on my phone.
Yeah, because
but
that's
the
what
thing is, those minutes we were voting on the minutes that were sent out to us as written. It was said three times as written. Those were the minutes that were sent out to us that had Craig as secretary and Pam as chairman. Now, if the group had listened to me and postponed the decision, we would have had time to look at that, because I thought there was something funny going on. I even said, there's something funny going on here. So we approved the minutes as written, which included Craig as...
I thought it was amended. Did you not say they were amended?
No, that's not what we were sent. We were...
You said just before the meeting they were amended.
If there's an error and somebody puts someone else's name in that signature block, does that put them in that position? I do understand. But
that's altering the minutes. Altering the minutes, and it's a felony.
It was amended.
That's an important point of what we need to cover, I think, today. Yeah. It's really, I don't want to steal where Ken's going, but when I went back and watched that videotape of the meeting, when Jody was asking about the minutes and there was a lot of comments back and forth, I watched that video and I said, and I watched it a week or two after the meeting, after having some meetings with Jody, based on all the comments that were made at that meeting, I felt like I did have some uncertainty on if we posted the right minutes, if my staff, the direction I gave them, if we put the right minutes on there or not. And that's part of what this discussion today is trying to lead us to, is what ones did we want to adopt, and did people, based on my phone call, make an assumption that there was going to be the corresponding change, and is that what they were voting on, or did other people not? And it wouldn't surprise me if we might have a little bit of a split amongst the group.
Commission Member Neal, I will tell you that the better practice, and I can tell you that Tom and I have done quite a bit of discussion together, the better practice is that when a draft set of minutes, particularly minutes, you know, minutes are the official record of what occurred at the meeting, very important, and if those have been sent out in some sort of a organized, formal way, by way of an email, which is perfectly a perfectly legitimate way to circulate them, and then there is a intervening change, the only way I would be comfortable with any change to even a semicolon on those minutes being approved would be if they had been handed out in front of your station at the meeting. And so you could literally, you know, do this. And quite frankly, even if that had occurred, because some board member may conclude that's simply another version of what they were emailed earlier, I would probably have been more comfortable if someone would have said, and here's the difference from what you had received in your inbox. So from that perspective, and based upon the motion that was made, we're moving to approve the minutes as, I think, written was the word.
Sure.
The version that you approved, I believe, was the version that contained Craig Nolen as the secretary.
Yeah. Let me ask you, because I know that people have errors in minutes. They approve them, and there's an error. I did a document compare of the minutes once they were posted on the web to the ones that we received. I saw that part and I thought, oh, well, that was a typo. I understand now that entire document, it all counts. But, you know, as far as what I thought the discrepancy was on, because I come to the 26th meeting not having a clue that any of this was going on. And I come to the 26th meeting, I understand there's a discrepancy that apparently that, you know, I read the minutes, said, okay, there are nominations. I guess I need to be there for elections because I wasn't at that part.
I see that, you know, I hear that there's some discussion about it and that there's an issue. And I know that Pam asked Craig, she said, well, if you want to preside over the meeting, you can. And Craig said no, and he seemed fine with it. And so I just took from that that it seemed like Craig was in agreement. If the discrepancy is over Craig, then I didn't see that there was a major concern about that whenever I saw that was in the minutes and I did a comparison.
And I appreciate it, and I do.
So what's the point of what you're, I understand what you just said.
Perspective from like the, not being involved in all of the discussion prior.
But now you've heard that a semicolon is a problem.
Sure.
So now you understand.
Well, I doubt that most places that have a semicolon in one actually have, you know, go and convict somebody.
Well, I'm talking about what it's saying. What Ken is saying is that the minutes were changed from showing Craig as secretary. They were changed to showing Pam as secretary, mm-hmm. and that was not done through the process that it's supposed to be done by legally. That's why it's called altering the minutes, and that's illegal and unethical. And it has a lot to do with who's running the meetings and stuff, you know.
Well, I understand if there was a certain intent. If there's a particular intent, then that would be unethical. If the minutes are still in the process of being drafted until we get there and there's an error, and there's no motive for that, then it's hard to understand why that would be.
Well, I don't.
It doesn't say, the law does not go to intent.
So ethics and errors are unethical. If somebody makes a mistake and you were saying that.
Have you read the law?
Yeah, that is that. Does that have to do with whether something is ethical or not?
That's
a pretty basic question.
All I wanted, let me just regroup for a second. I don't think anybody is suggesting that after they were approved, they were subsequently modified. I think the problem is the commission is unclear on what it voted on that evening. That's what I want to get to the bottom of. But I'll tell you again, I think the only realistic view we could have was that you voted on what you received in your inbox. Because I know anything modified was not sent to you, and at most you got a verbal communication on it. And that's challenging. That's real challenging for you all to be able to, you know, and of course Tom and I have talked about this, and I can guarantee you and I can commit to you that the next time you have a meeting involving approval of minutes, those minutes are going to be in front of you on what you're approving. So I know that's going to be the case as well.
And I made a big production out of trying to get us to see the minutes. And even when the rest of the board voted, I never was even called on to vote. I mean, it's on the tape. You know, all in favor, four people raised their hands. The next thing that came out of Pam's mouth was, motion passes 4-1. The next thing, I'm sitting here waiting for somebody, maybe the attorney or somebody, to say, when are you going to ask for those opposed? So I said,
you must have thought I saw your hand. Because I always make a special effort to make sure I look.
Well, you that time.
I made a mistake. I'm
sorry.
You
sure did, and it was a doozy. But
well, you do lots of doozies, Jody.
The problem, the whole thing is, I tried my darndest to avoid this situation by trying to say, let's postpone, since we don't know. And we've got one member here that's not sure of what's in the minutes, even though, or what we're voting on. I'm not real sure. I made that absolutely clear. And my feeling would be that if you've got a member that's not clear on the minutes, then you ought to postpone it. And I made it clear that I wanted to postpone it. And nobody even seconded it. And if y'all had voted to postpone it, which was, that's not either voting for it or against it, it's just so that we can see it.
Okay, I think
and y'all didn't,
we understand what your point is right now. Can we move on from this? Can we get on to the next?
Well, the point is that I was not trying to steer a decision one way or the other. I was just trying to do the right thing. And the right thing would have been to postpone it. Do y'all see that now? Or do y'all still think that I'm wrong?
It's not a right or a wrong. Have we?
There is a right or a wrong.
We're not judging you as right or wrong, is what I said.
What I said, and I didn't get a response.
I don't think you're going to get a response. We're listening to everything you say, and I think we've already heard it.
I see a disagreement that, to me, it seems like we could have addressed this as a board. It's a very simple issue. I mean, we have a tie vote on one that we can resolve. There's not even a public hearing this month, so we can have another work session before there's even a public hearing. And there is another one that was already, I mean, there was support for him to become, whether he's nominated or elected, it seems like there was overwhelming support. So it seems like that there's nothing that would change directionally from this.
I agree with that. I don't think the purpose of this, and yes, that is a purpose of this meeting, but I think another purpose of this meeting, though, is to basically just allow this sort of discussion, because there's been a lot of discussion about this everywhere, you know, other than here. And quite frankly, I think some of it needed to occur here in front of everyone so everyone can respond in real time. We're all here in the same thing. I wanted it. And I will say to you, Doctor, that with respect to the February 26th meeting, I would like to think that if I had been there, I would have responded in a way differently. I don't know that I can do that to my lawyer, and I think that was a challenging time for him. But to the extent that a member at any board raises their hand and says, "I don't know what I'm voting on," he will do better.
But the big point, and this is where I was trying to get an answer on, I get the feeling that you don't understand that, and you don't understand it, and you don't understand that.
Did you not go over and question staff about those minutes? I distinctly remember you getting up and going over there.
I've got a lot of questions about the conversations that the two of y'all had with staff. You know, who knows?
That was at our public hearing at the meeting.
But the point I'm trying to say is y'all keep arguing the point of it was perfectly fine to not have the not postpone the meeting. And the point I'm trying to make is,
we had heard that it had been changed.
Can't y'all see that was not the right thing to do? The right thing to do was to postpone the meeting. I didn't even get a second on that. And I'm not saying sour grapes or anything. I'm just trying to get some kind of ethical consciousness going on that's not the right thing to do when you've got somebody that's not clear on what it is. And it turned out that I had a perfect right to not be clear, because what y'all voted on was wrong. But the biggest problem is you need to understand that that's not the right way to do it. The laws are made to protect the minority. The majority gets what they want, but you have laws written that protect the minority. That's why we have these laws. That's why when I'm sitting here saying I want to read the minutes and I get bulldozed, then the law comes into play. You know, because I'm the minority that got run over. And y'all can't, all I'm asking is You can't see that? Can you see it?
I felt comfortable that the body of the minutes were correct.
You felt comfortable that...
I felt comfortable the body of the minutes...
I felt that the body, the minutes were, everything that was written inside the minutes were as correct as we possibly could get without having the whole thing on tape.
Do you get what I'm trying to say?
I mean, I generally would trust that whatever minutes we receive from staff when they say that those are the minutes, that...
You can't blame it on staff. Staff?
I'm not blaming it on staff.
We are responsible.
I don't think that that was a... I mean, I don't see that, in my view,
okay,
it would be
made
hard
bad
for me to have understood.
That just does not compute in my upbringing.
Fine, can we move on, please?
Yeah, let me just kind of wrap up this. Let me wrap up this way. I mean, we've gone through this and churned over it, and thank you for the indulgence of doing this. Couple of housekeeping things. You know, right now on the county's website is a version of the February, I'm going to get this right, Tom, the February 19th minutes.
Yes.
That does not contain the Craig Nolen as the secretary.
Right.
And I believe that's wrong. I believe the version that you moved and approved on the 26th was the version that you received in your email.
And somebody changed it from what we approved. They changed it to what we've got right now. And it was not, and it didn't go through the process of, what is the process for changing the minutes? Because I've been told before that, and this is something that, I don't know if you know this or not, but this is exactly what I've been told, is if you go to a meeting and you say something is black, and it's on tape that you said black, but the minutes come over here and say it's white, and people have approved the minutes, the minutes are the be-all, end-all.
Well,
you said white. That's what will hold up in court, not what you really said. It's what's on the minutes. That's how important the minutes are and why they need to be accurate.
So how do you change that?
Well,
I agree with that. I agree that the minutes are the official judicially recognized document of what occurred in the meeting. But if the minutes, if using your black and white example, what's supposed to happen is if the board understands that the minutes are wrong, they need to clarify by way of a motion and second. And
by God, I tried.
Well, but see, I don't think we're talking about minutes that were approved and now are being tweaked. I think the problem is what got put up on the web page.
Yeah.
That's the problem. And we have a version of the minutes that has Craig Nolen as the secretary. And I'm recommending to staff that after following this work session, those minutes get put up on the county website. I'm not talking about changing the minutes. I believe those are the minutes you approved based upon the information I have. And if they're wrong, there's a process for changing.
And what is that process?
It would be to put it on another work session or another regular meeting and have a motion to change the minutes.
If you don't do that and the minutes are changed.
That's a problem.
Yeah, and it can be a felony because it's called altering the minutes.
Well, but again, I want to be very clear. I'm not accusing anybody of doing anything because, as far as that's concerned, because we're talking about two drafts, competing drafts, and the wrong, bottom line, I think the wrong draft got put up on the county webpage. I think you approved the minutes that contained the Craig Nolen signature block. I don't have any other way to say it. You approved the minutes that were circulated on February 25th. That's what I believe. Tom, do you concur?
Yeah, after watching the video, I agree with that.
So that needs to be, that's the first thing that needs to be addressed. And if anybody wants to change those minutes, we need to put it on a subsequent work session or subsequent board meeting, and there's a protocol for that.
Okay. Well, I just want to say one more thing, and that is before when you talked with us, you talked about your kids in the bright line and getting up close to the bright line. And your statement was, and that bright line is the difference between the ethics, and then it crosses over to Italy. And you have told us, in no uncertain terms, to stay as far away from that bright line as we can.
Yes, sir.
Not to bump up against it.
Yes, sir.
And the problem is, even after you've told us that, we still have people that are bumping up against it. And that's what was happening on this, is we had people bumping up against that bright line. But unfortunately, this time, they went over the bright line a little bit. And that's the rub, you know, because trying to bump up against that bright line.
Okay, I think we've heard enough.
So we are only talking about the signatures, is that correct?
Yeah, we're talking about signatures, that's it.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
There was nothing done inside the body of any of these meetings, their minutes.
I'm not aware of that.
That's...
Did either of you all tell Teresa to change the minutes?
I didn't tell Teresa to change any minutes.
When I read the minutes that were sent to me, the word appointed or nominated, and I went over that, that's what helped bring this all out, was my...
I questioned
how that had happened.
So you
I questioned it.
So you questioned it. You questioned it, and then you took it on yourself to change it, or did she ask you to change it?
No, sir.
No, that's prior to the draft going out.
I'm just talking about what caused things to happen.
Wasn't that the summary you were talking about?
My question is...
The summary.
That was the summary. Did you ask Teresa to change what was going on, or did Teresa take it on herself?
No, it was the summary that I asked that had been posted online. It didn't correspond with the rest of the minutes, and they all needed to be the same.
Did you ask
it's
her?
In my timeline that I've given the county attorney.
She emailed, yes.
And ask her to change the minutes.
No, that's not the minutes, the meeting summary.
Change the meeting summary.
Right. She identified that there was an inconsistency.
So somebody made a decision to change the summary.
No, they just wanted to make them consistent.
Yes, we made a decision. The staff made a decision.
They made the decision that there was an inconsistency.
Isn't that an ordinary protocol? I mean, that's not unusual. If somebody takes minutes and they find that there was a concern about
the agenda summary is different than the minutes. The agenda summary is supposed to be a short, concise snapshot available very shortly after a meeting to let folks know generally, not specifically, but generally what business took place. So to the extent that one said appoint and one said nominate, that would be a conflict between the summary and the minutes.
But you would be working towards making sure that the minutes were approved or that the minutes are correct.
Right.
At that point.
Mm-hmm. Right. I mean, to me, the issue that we really need to focus on are the minutes. I mean, that's got much more legal teeth. Now, don't get me wrong, I want the agenda summary to be as correct as we can make it as well. Mm-hmm. That is a document required by the Open Meetings Act, but sure. The minutes.
But we're saying here, I've heard it said that we knew that Craig Nolen was elected secretary, but we want to change that to nominate.
No, we thought he was until we looked at the sheet and it was never closed, the nomination.
You know, part of the problem that's just, it's obvious within this discussion is that we had commission members thinking that there's protocols that are ongoing and clearly they're not shared by everyone. Clearly they're not.
Well, the obvious thing is that most people walked out of the meeting clearly thinking that we had elected somebody.
Well,
and then all of a sudden this nominate gets brought up by you two to Teresa. And if it hadn't been for that, we wouldn't...
Well, and I brought it up because I wanted things to be accurate.
But you, but what you were saying was not accurate. What you
may
were
I finish?
Informing her was not accurate.
May I finish?
Yeah.
I wanted things to be accurate, and as I went over and over the meeting, in my head, I knew that we had not completed what we were supposed to complete with the election process.
Was that because you wanted to be chairman?
No.
And you didn't want?
It didn't, we were not talking about chairman, we were talking about secretary. And I knew that I had said, I nominate Craig Nolen to be secretary, and we voted, got a second and we voted, but we never closed the nominations or moved any further.
Could I ask you a question?
Yes.
Just out of good faith, interest in knowing, because it does help me, because I've certainly gotten feedback from Dr. Moses on what he intended. And don't get me wrong, you know, in the world of parliamentary procedure, what you intended may not be the end-all be-all. But when you made your motion, forget about the protocols that were handed out at the end of the meeting. What was your intention?
My intention was to nominate Craig, and then after he was nominated,
the two-step process.
To close the nominations and then have a vote.
Why didn't you
That's
tell me to do that?
That's how it's normally done that way.
Why didn't you tell her to do that?
It's not
You had an opportunity. It is your place to tell her that. Why didn't you do that? Why didn't you, rather than go call staff and start trying to involve staff in this, why didn't you just go on and say, Pam, we
haven't finished. Because I think everyone's so confused already that night.
There's a suggestion on the table that the change to the meeting summary drove the final minutes that were sent out, and that's not the case.
Well, now, but I'm still back on this, on the meeting. How in the world can you possibly sit there and say it was a nomination? I worried about it for days because it was a nomination when you had all the opportunity in the world. Not only an opportunity, you had the obligation to tell the chairman, you know, because you were going by nomination. You had the obligation to tell her that we need to go on and finish up with the vote. Now, with you not doing that, that leads me, and it would lead everybody else to
You
vote.
Were there and you didn't do
Don't
it
Don't interrupt
either.
Me, please.
You
that would lead
too.
Everybody to believe that you felt like that the election was over because you had a perfect opportunity to an obligation to do that, but yet you go
Jody,
home and worry about it.
I will tell you that I did not realize that we did not complete that until later on that night and the next day. That's when it hit me. We did not complete the process. That's when it hit me. It didn't hit me then.
The fact of the matter is we did complete it.
Actually, we did not.
I'm done with respect to this issue. I mean, I think it has done exactly what I hoped it would do, which is we've at least had a clearing of the air. I mean, whatever can be said about this, I think we've been candid with one another, and that's been helpful to me. From the standpoint of moving forward, my recommendation is to get the minutes up there that I think were approved, so I don't want anybody be surprised when that occurs. That is not manipulation of the minutes. That is, in fact, in my opinion, putting up the correct minutes. Number two,
well, those minutes show Pam as chairman.
They would still, because that's what was handed. That's because that's
what
we
voted on.
Yes.
So, okay.
And the same for the minutes we prepare for the 26th. They would have that as well. Pam is.
Pam is chairman.
Well,
because the minutes say that Pam is chairman. She is the chairman, so we don't need to vote. Because legally, in a court of law, you go to a judge and you say, these are the minutes, and he's going to say.
Now, we have to vote because we have to break this tie today per rule, per the bylaws.
Okay. There hasn't been an election until I vote. Is that the way it is? Like, is it not concluded until I vote?
Well,
yes.
Yeah. Let me mention one other thing. I think we've got a couple people here that are a little disingenuous, and for them to serve as chairman.
You know, I mean,
for them to serve as is our leader.
I think that will be reflected on your vote, whatever the outcome is.
From my perspective, just kind of being new to the board, I say that there's a lot of mistrust between different people on the board, and there's no real procedures in place, which we probably need for voting, just so that we don't have these kind of issues in the future.
And just to give you a little history, prior to Mr. Moses being on this board, we have never had these issues ever. In my 16 years of being on this board, has this ever happened at all, even close? No, everyone agreed, and everyone worked as a team, which you do not do.
I follow the rules.
You don't work as a team, and this is supposed to be a team for the betterment of Forsyth County. And that's all it is. It's not for any gain, no political gain. We're a citizen board. No. No.
You all have indulged me.
I'm just going to say that that rings hollow. Because there
Let's
has been
on.
Financial gain.
Not because of this appointment in any way, shape, or form.
And I'm just...
Number two, final action.
I would like to see
us
elect somebody with some integrity, is all. And that's what I'm trying to say to you.
Okay, let's move on.
It doesn't look like we've got that right here.
Final action regarding the tie vote for Pam Livesay for chairman, postponed by rule from the February 19th work session.
With the understanding, now that you've been made it very clear, you do not want to serve in that capacity.
Exactly.
Having said that, we are where we are procedurally, so again, just humor me on this as well. Teresa, can you tell us what the vote totals were at the February 19th meeting? What was it? Was it Commissioner Moses and Commissioner Nolen in favor of Pam Livesay?
Yes, sir.
And then Commissioners Livesay and Commissioner Bowman
again.
Opposed? All right, that is, for this evening's minutes, that needs to be the vote totals this evening. And now we are then, before we vote, if you'll indulge me, we are in discussion. And then there will be, you'll call the vote, and the only person that votes is you.
Okay.
Once again, I have asked not to be reappointed after 16 years on this board. Therefore, I would decline any nomination to be chairman.
Okay.
Any other discussion? Is there a vote?
Just you. Vote against.
All right. Number three, depending on the outcome of Livesay vote, election of the chairman, if necessary, I would like to move that we elect Pam Bowman chairman of the Planning Commission Board.
And I would like to move that we elect Neal.
Do we have a second?
Do we have?
I asked for elections. I did not nominate. I elected.
Right, right.
No nomination.
You have to wait for appropriate time for a second, and then we'll have to hear your vote.
Is there a second?
A second.
Any discussion?
I would like to move that we elect Alan Neal as chairman.
Okay, we have to vote on the motion that's on the table right now first, correct?
That's correct.
All in favor of Pam Bowman as chairman, please vote. All declining? Pam Bowman, please vote. The vote carries 3-1. All right, next is final action regarding the nomination of Craig Nolen for secretary.
That has been done.
This is a matter that I think out of an abundance, you know, here's where we are. To the extent that he has been elected, that is on the minutes as far as in the signature block. If you want to ratify that decision, that's perfectly fine. If you feel like it was not done properly the first time,
But just note that the minutes from that meeting reflected that he was.
Can I also ask at this point, should Pam Bowman start?
Pam Bowman take over?
The meeting?
Yes, actually, chairman, yes.
We just handed it over.
Yes.
Okay, so do you want to go over what you just said again about?
Yeah, the issue was, you know, this is the key, right? I mean, there is a difference of opinion as to whether Craig Nolen was in fact appointed or elected to be the secretary at the February 19th meeting. It seems to me everybody in the meeting hall that night thought that he was, right? I mean, I did. I walked out thinking he was as well. I know the words used were nominate. My point is, I think if you take no action right now, you're fine. If you choose to ratify his appointment as secretary, that's fine too. That's the way. Let me just put it to you this way. If I was in front of the Board of Commissioners and there was uncertainty at all, I just have them ratified. It just cleans it up. But I'm just saying, I don't think you have to do that. But if you want to, that's fine.
No, I think we probably should do that.
I think
that would be the safest thing for us to do. So do you make a motion to ratify his appointment as secretary?
You'd make a motion to ratify Craig Nolen as the secretary.
Then I'll make the motion to ratify Craig Nolen as secretary.
I second.
Please vote.
Only problem I have is I hope that you read the minutes or the bylaws and not have to ask that question that you just asked before you call for a vote. As chairman, I hope that you will bone up on how to run a meeting.
Jody, we're not in discussion. Let's let the chair preside.
You can talk with Pete over here.
Craig Nolen is
now
the secretary.
Now,
depending upon the outcome of the Nolen vote, election of a secretary if necessary. Down to number six is review and discussion regarding pending applications currently in the applicant's work time. Teresa?
You have your sheets. If you have any questions on any of the items that are on here, you're welcome to ask me any questions. It's really just a sheet to give you some guidance if someone were to give you some phone calls when the signs go up for public participation. It's just a brief summary of what we have currently, the files that are in my office, and the files that are going upstairs to the Board of Commissioners. So.
Anybody have any questions? Moving on to number seven, no applications were submitted for the scheduled March 26, 2013 public hearing, so that meeting has been canceled. And now, do I have a motion for adjournment?
So moved.
Have a second?
Second.
Please vote. Vote is 4-1 with Commissioner Nolen being absent.
Thank you, Mr. Members. Thank you.
Thank you.
I know that was glorious. Thank you.
Good job, Ken.
Thank you, Ken.
It's amazing. Let's see. Swap those back.
Yes. I'm going to the dentist today, so.
And then if a member wants to put
see you later, Pete. You need this?
Do
you need to have your folder? Or in your folder? You don't want them?
Good job.
Thank you.
Jody, are you having trouble with your knee? I saw you had a cane.
Back.
Oh, your back? It's safe going home, Vanessa.
Oh,
I know you have a way to go.
I do.
See you later.
Bye, Nydia.
Good night, Pam.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye. Have a good evening.
Thank you, John. See you later.
Yep.